Hi Lovey guys, today I am coming up with a super game which was played in a Uppsala chess tournament. What's the best part of in this game is the end game position, which is very rare to appear in high level of chess playing. That's why I choose this game. Let's not further waste time and let's go and check it. Hi guys, in this game white played by the Hilla Persian Tiger. He is rating around 2543. He is a grandmaster. Let's see how he is going to play. And he started with d4. And black was played by Seo Jung Min. He is also a very strong international master. He is an IM and his rating is 2471. Let's see how he is going to defend against Persian. He started with d5. After this, c4. It is Queen's Gambit on the board, guys. Let's see how black going to defend. So black chose to play c6, slave defense. After this, white moved e3. Usually, a lot of Queen's Gambit player don't like to play e3 before releasing the bishop on c1, because they don't want to play with a very passive bishop. That's why they will always intends to develop the bishop towards the f4. But in this position, Hilla went for e3. Let's see how he is going to hold this position, because it is also a very standard opening. Let's see guys. In this position, black played knight f6, white played bishop to d3, e6, knight f3, c5, and white continued with simply w. So Hilla doesn't care about what may happen on the center. He only concentrate on developing the pieces and make the king in safe place. So in this position, after a castle, black continued with c into d4, e into d4, d into c4. In this position, bishop into c4 was played. After seeing this position, you can ask, it is a very singled pawn. Will it be a weakness or not? Actually, singled pawn is weakness, guys. But if you see clearly, just assume these four ranks are for white. Okay, these four ranks are for white. This half a board is for white, and next half a board is for black. If you are having a singled pawn within your camp, so you don't worry about the single pawn, because you can support it easily. That's why you don't need to worry about getting single pawn. In this position, after bishop into c4, black went for bishop e7. He's also planned to castle. After this, queen e2 was played. Very standard and a very logical move, guys, because this queen controlling the e4 square, which is very important square for white to make progress. That's why queen e2 is very logical, guys. After this, black went for castle. Knight c3 was played. Knight bd7. Guys, let's see. Jung Min planned to place his knight in d5 square. That's why he developed his knight towards the d7 square, because the actual plan is after d7, it will come to the b6 square and then come to d5, because d5 is very much needed for black to launch an attack. That's why he chose to play knight b to d7. After knight to bd7, white continued with rook to d1. It is very very logical, guys. Black continued with knight b6 as he's planned, and it attacking the bishop, so bishop have to move. Bishop comes to b3. The actual plan is bishop will come to c2 and launch attack towards the king side. Then black played knight bd2, d5. After this, white continued with knight to e5. Bishop d7 was played. Finally, black developing his undeveloped pieces towards the d7 square. The actual plan is it will come to c6 and it will keep eye on king side. Okay, in this position, guys, what will you play? There is a very logical move. Hilip went for a very good move, that is rook to d3. See guys, in board there are all pieces are still on the board. None of the minor pieces get exchanged, but he developing his rook towards the center and go for attack. Very active plan. Let's see how he is going to continue. In this position, white went for bishop to c6. After bishop to c6, it is looking at g2 pawn. In this position, white continued with rook to g3. The rook to g3 move not only the supporting the g2 but also attacking the g7 pawn. So in this position, black continued with knight into c3, b into c3, b in bishop e4. The actual plan is bishop is going to hide on g6 in order to avoid rook threats to g7. In this position, white continued with bishop to h6. The actual plan is threatening to capture the g7 square. So in this position, bishop go for g6, hiding the active line of rook. But in this position, white continue with knight into g6. Now your turn guys, what will you capture first, bishop or knight? In this position, Jing Meng capture h into g6. That is a very good move, because you can't capture g into h6. You can see it right, the knight is going to capture the rook, and it will not only capture the rook, and it will also give discover attack by rook. Let's see, knight will capture the rook and king will capture the knight, and this rook is very active in this line, and the king side is totally collapsed. That's why in this position, you have to capture the knight first. So Jing Meng capture the knight. After this, bishop have to move and go to safe square. The very logical move is bishop to d2, support the c3 pawn. After this, and black continue with knight to h5, attacking the rook. The actual good move for rook is rook to h3, but in this position, Hilip went for rook to f3. After this, black played queen to d6. Very logical to play, because you have to develop your pieces and launch attack as soon as possible. In this position, white moved rook to e1. After this, black continued with rook a8. G4 was played, so attacking the knight. So knight have to move. Knight moves to f6, and again Hilip went for g5. You can see he is attacking knight continuously, and knight again comes to knight to h5. After this move, white played logical move. He also want to centralize his queen, so he moved queen to e4. After this, black continued with bishop to d8. The very logical idea is bishop will come to c7, and queen will attack this pawn on h2. But Hilip know this, and he moved rook to h3. As I said before, the rook h3 is best move guys on that move. That's why I say that rook h3 is very good. But okay, now let's see how Hilip continued. In this position, black went for e4. So he want to open up the position and launch attack as soon as possible. But after this move, white went for f4. Very brave decision guys. In this position, queen goes to queen to d7, attacking this rook on h3. Before moving to queen d7, why not you can capture this pawn? For example, in this position, suppose black continue with e into f4, then white idea is queen into e8. So rook into e8, queen into e8, check. And if queen is come towards the f8, and you will capture the queen, and you are going to win after you are getting the piece up. That's why king have to move king h7. But in this position, there is a very good move, that is bishop to c2, and you will lose this poor knight. And in this position, there is nothing to play, because it is going to checkmate on this line. If you play with bishop into g5, you can prolong the game, but you can't win by this passive ideas. That's why after e into f4 position is not working. You can ask me what will happen if in this position knight captures the f4 pawn. If knight captures the f4 pawn, again the position will lead to favor for the white. Let's see, bishop into f4. So queen d7. You have to support this rook before opening the open file. Let's see, in this position white has a very good move, that is rook e3. It also support the rook. Okay, the plan is if e into f4 was played. Now your turn, guys. Can you find the very best move for white? Yeah, that best move is queen into g6. It will get made, and it will get made very soon. That's why in this position after f4, Jungmin can't capture the pawn. That's why in this position black went for queen to d7, attacking the rook on h3. But Hilap went for rook into h5, and black played queen to g4 check. In this position Hilap chose to play exchanging the queen, so he played queen to g2. In this position black has a choice to take rook with his queen. But the thing is, if you capture the rook with your queen, the problem is bishop comes to d1, attacking the queen, and the queen have to come h4 or h7. H7 is very passive, that's why he have to come to h4. But the problem is, after f into e5, the queen doesn't have good square to move. It is very passive on h4. That's why in this position Jungmin go for queen into g2 variation. After this, king into g2 was played, g into f5, g into h5, f into e5. After this position reached, there are a lot of moves has played, but that is not very impressive. That is not very important. So I will go first and cover all those moves. In this position, black went for g6, c4 was played, bishop e7, c5, king g7, improving his king position. After this, white went for king f3, rook c8. So actual plan is b6 idea. So white played rook to c1. So if black go for a b6 idea, he will push it and make this pawn as a possible pawn. That's why black can't push b6. After this, rook fd8 was played. White continue with bishop to e3, rook e8, king e4, bishop d8, h4 to support this pawn and make stable of this pawn structure. Make stable the structure. Black played bishop to c7, bishop to d5, rook b8. So again he is going to move b6 idea. So in this position white continue with rook f1, threatening to capture this f7 pawn. So black have to forcefully move rook to e7, rook f6. So now you can't play this move because rook also, now this rook also controlling this b6 square. After this, black continue with rook b8, bishop f4, rook b8, bishop b3, king f8, bishop d2, king g7, bishop c3, rook b8, a4. The main idea is to make some disturbance by playing a6. black played king f8, a5, king g7, rook f1. The main idea of white is to open up the position and go for attack. That's why he went back his rook to f1 and planned to place it on rook to a1. So in this position, black continued with bishop to b8, a6, so disturbing the b7 pawn. After this, black played b6. As I said earlier, he moved c6. It is very good posture right now. Let's see how he is going to continue. Bishop c7 was played. Bishop b4, it is threatening to capture the rook, and unfortunately black doesn't have a good square for his rook, so he is going to lose his exchange up. After this, bishop b8 was played, bishop into e7, rook into e7, bishop c4, bishop c7, rook f6, king f8. In this position, guys, can you guess what Hilep did? In this position, he went for bishop into f7. He sacrificed his next pieces. Very amazing, right? That's why I like this position. In this position, black played rook into f7. After this, white played d5. Just see, guys, he has three passer pawn right now. In this position, black played bishop to d8. Hilep has an option like rook into f7, but he didn't go for that line. He knew he will win for sure. That's why he played d6. In this position, black played bishop into f6, g into f6, king e8 was played. Look, guys, these four pawns are in central. It is very rare to appear on a high level playing. Black doesn't have enough power to solve this kind of attack. These four pawns are monsters. So in this position, white continued with c7. King comes to d7. Can you guess what the move Hilep went for? And this is the position I put as a thumbnail in for this video. Can you guess what's the move? The move is e6. After Hilep went for e6, black is in the game. Hilep won the game. See, guys, how beautiful it is. If you captured this pawn, and you will, and white will promote the pawn as queen. If king go for c8, and he will lose his rook, and eventually this pawn will promote as a queen, and white will win. That's why in this position, Zheng Ming resigned the game and Hilep win. I think you all love the game. If you are loving this game, kindly subscribe and support the channel. Let me see you on another video. Thank you.